Hello guys and friends all over the world. At last we have printed the new book on how to guide volumes, the first one of the series. And this time is a little different from what we usually publish. It is dedicated to female modeling miniatures. And the author, maybe you know from already from other editions, is Christos Katselos, one of the best in this field. And some years ago, he suggested to do a special book on females, because we saw that a lot of people are interested to see how the master artist paint their figures. This is a new book in a new series, as I told you, and we have a lot of step-by-step chapters, so the reader can understand everything easily and without any hidden secrets. Christos reveals all of his secrets, and I think that anyone who will purchase this book will be satisfied more than enough. Let's see what is inside. We have divided in 11 chapters, as always our friend and supporter all these years, Alex Vallejo, close 2 pages of advertising, and please check out their products because are excellent. And all this book, all these paintings, they have been done using Vallejo products. It was something that we designed for over 2 years and came in reality just 2 months ago. So the quality of the painting, as you know, Christos masterpieces. This is the 41st book that we published to date, and Christos shows us how to paint female figures and busts, also from cinema characters or fantasy or real people, real personality like Marilyn Monroe. A lot of different themes, also from fantasy, Luftrig 1919, and we go together in this. Also, I have to quote that Christos used about 65 different colors, to have a variety to flesh, to different textures, and not to be repeating the same mixes as we can see in other editions. And the first 52 pages are devoted to a lot of step-by-step projects, about 200 illustrations, enabling the reader to easily understand and follow the sequence. The remainder of the book has 4 articles with more photos of the finished models and the necessary, of course, text. We must thank, a big thank must go to Christos Katselos, a great artist, for giving us the opportunity to publish his work and share his secrets. Also, we have to thank all our regulars, friends and supporters. Pietro Balloni, Luca Marchetti, Alex Vallejo, Darren Parker Mead, Manjin Kim, Alexei Lukanev, Fernando Vallejo, Tyson Harms, Andrew Kearns, Yang Binsang, Yong Hin Kim, Yuvon Jung, Paul on Deck, Sang-Eon Lee, Yannis Papadopoulos, and of course our English editor and very good friend of mine, Ken Jones. So we start what is inside. Enough for the introduction. The first chapter is introduction. We don't know if everyone knows how to start, what he will need. This is also some tips that Christos is using. And also here he mentioned the difference of painting a female skin than a male skin. So this is very important to read before start anything else. And also to see the tools that you must have in your workbench. Most of you, if you are modelers, you have most of this. This is the introduction, the palette that Christos liked to use, the glues, some brushes, thinners, and as I told you, most of this inside are from Vallejo series. And then we go for a detail preparing and assembling a resin miniature. It's a detail article, so you can see some secrets how to handle these blocks, the resin blocks, without destroying the detail. Remove this without destroying the detail. And most of these figures coming from live miniatures because their females are excellent. It's 1, 2, 3, 4 from live miniatures, one from I don't remember the name. It's something 3D. It's 9th yet miniatures, the black dark skin. This is from Andrea, and the other two fantasy. It's from Luftkrieg series. That is by Stephen Andrew. So we go to see what is inside. This is something that everyone will find interesting and useful because you must know how to handle these tiny resin parts. Everything explained here. Using cutters easily, and be careful not to destroy the parts of the kit. You see some tips how to remove the small remaining. And Christos also use special goggles. Sanding sticks, handmade sanding sticks, clippers, and of course some tips for pinning and removing these strange blocks with saw and we can say and of course you have to prepare the base that you put your miniature so not to have a very bad experience to leave the wooden base and destroyed. Go on with the two-part epoxy. Silmasta is one of the best in the field for cyanoacrylic and epoxy parts, two-part glue. You see how this work in detail, everything in detail, so no one have any questions. With intentionally here, Christos leave a small gap, so to see how to use the two-part epoxy putty to fill small gaps without destroying the rest of the miniature. So this is very detailed also on preparing and assembling without having any problems and make your life easier. You can see here, you have to clean it with warm water and soap, detergent or detergent, and then Christos likes to paint with black after the primer. And this is the figure going on with the painting sequence, and you see the steps. You can see the difference very easily. The quality is absolutely perfect, and you see here step by step the painting from all angles. And here is going on. The final result is astonishing. You can see here the result of Christos. This is 1/24 scale, 75 millimeters. So it's about the real size, about here. So it's, this is, photo is double the size, the real size. Okay. So you can see every detail of the painting and the smooth flesh painting. Okay, and this is also a palette for using colors, diluted colors. This is also the mixes. You can see the mixes for all this, for the hair and everything. Go on for the second one. This is very, I liked very much the style and the attitude, we can say. Stand Alone from Fictional Universe. Life Miniatures again, and here you can see also the sequence of painting and pre-shading with black and white, and everything written with detail, and the mixes all in sequence and step by step. I think that this is very important to see that Christos uses very thin paint and glazes, a lot of glazes, to eliminate the brush strokes, So you can see each time the difference, but very, very smooth transition to one from the highlight to shadow and base color. You can see here the backpack, then the metals, and here the finished model. I think it's one of the best painting I have seen, along with the artist Angeoli. And this is with other lighting and more light, the backpack and the other sides. See, here it's the Voodoo Lady. It's something different because we wanted to show how to paint a dark skin. And this is came from Ninth Gate Miniatures. It's a strange scale. It's 1/14, 130 millimeters, because it is 3D model, but it's the quality of the sculpting, and the casting is perfect. And see here the step-by-step sequence, how to paint the flesh. This is most dedicated to flesh, not to other garments. But you have everything you need to paint this girl, the Voodoo Lady. Everything is written here, but we decided to give more depth in painting the flesh and this dark skin and eyes, and not so many of the other and the other elements. But you can have an idea how to paint, because we have included all angles of the painted model. I think it's one of the best I have seen in painted in the world. Also, this is again from Life Miniatures. Surrounded, it's painted from the Fictional Universe series. You can see this girl trying to survive from zombies, from mutiny people. Again, we have a lot of step-by-step figures, all the necessary mixes here. You see here, I'd love this action pose, and this also we give more more careful, more some more photos for painting the puppy, because a lot of people wants to know how to paint a dog. Christos analyzed here how to paint this nice small dog, the puppy, so you can have a very good reference for future, for your future paintings. This is very intense scene, I think, with the gun and this also this. So this is with the back in in the wall. So I think this also will be very good to see how this is all about, how this painted. We are very sure that a book for girls must be have a dedicated, at least a dedicated chapter for painting eyes. Also, this is the painted color chips, and we use one of the Life Miniatures Boost. You know the girl is Princess Grace from Monaco, but we use only how to paint the eyes. The eyes is blue, light blue, and you can see how this can be done easily with Christos' advice. And you can see the color chips, the painting that we use for this painting. I think this is also very useful for everyone, not only for the people that want to paint girls, for everyone. This is now the, this from now and for the last pages, we have finished models, but very attractive painting. Christos have done this before, decided to do the book, so we add these articles, but this is very exceptional sculpting, and I don't know why we don't see very often these paintings. Also, this is 1/16 scale, 120 millimeter, and the details of the sculpting and casting are very, very good. You can see here the raw model. I like it very much, this series, and when I saw this painted, already painted in Christos' book vitrine, bookcase, I think I was very astonished, and I told him to prepare also these articles. The details are here, the how to paint the arrows, everything. You can see the nice green color for Yumiko. Also, this is from the same this girl is from the same series, Luftrick 1919, 120 millimeters, again from fantasy world, a little fantasy, but is, I think you find very interesting to give a try to paint something like that, and everything is written here, the mixes and all, and you can see from all angles how to paint and make the smooth transition that Christos succeeded here. I liked very much also this painted figure, and an old but classical, I think, miniature from Andrea. Subway Wind, it's an Andrea miniature 54 millimeter, classical, white metal, and I like it very much, so I also ask Christos to make a small article about this figure, because I like it very much. This is also a very good painting, also was finished, was already painted when we decided to do the book, and we added here with some more details, and of course all the mixes that Christos used for painting the Mary Monroe Boost, again from Life Miniatures. I think it will be very, very, very useful for everyone to have this book. Check it out to your local dealer and from our web, but I think we'd love to, you like it, to have in your library a book like this. You have it all for painting a fair skin, a female skin, so you can check it out also in your local dealer and shop. Thank you very much, see you again.